Literally just finished recording this video, then I got some other breaking news related to this. The release date, that's what it was, which is the reason we're re-recording this. But before we get into the release date, we have to first talk about what the release date is even for. And that is for none other than what you're seeing on the screen right now. As you guys can see from Xbox, officially from Xbox, let's make it official. The Xbox Series S, next gen performance in the smallest Xbox ever. At $299. And I know everyone, when they first look at it, the first thing that's going to pop up is how stupid Xbox's naming schemes are. Like, holy crap, dude, why did you have to choose letters that sound so similar to each other? The Xbox Series X and S, you know how many times people are going to get confused with that? Like, it's going to be annoying. But the second thing that probably stood out to you is the price at being at $299. Like, yo, if it's at $299, it must suck, right? Because, like, if you think about the rumored prices for the Series X and the PlayStation 5, those are rumored to be like $500, $600. So if it's at $300, it must suck. But then I took a look at the specs, because some specs have been revealed, and holy crap, this may be the greatest deal in gaming. For the price you're paying for the specs you get, it could just be insane. Maybe there's a catch to this somewhere that I haven't realized, but I don't think there is, because this looks really, really good. And I'll put this on screen for you guys right now to look at. But if we start with the top left, we can see it starts off saying all digital, so no optical drive, no discs, which personally I don't care about, because I've been running all digital since PS3, so not really that big of a deal to me. And I know some people still use discs, but let's be honest, games just run better when they're digital. So, you know, just leave it at that. I'm not going to get into that whole thing, but digital is better. But then we have 1440p at up to 120 frames per second. Yo, DirectX ray tracing, variable rate shading, variable refresh rate, ultra low latency, custom 512 gigabyte SSD, 4K streaming media playback, 4K upscaling for games. Like, holy crap, let's calm down, Xbox. Like, for that price, and I know a lot of people are going to say, well, that's not as good as the Xbox Series X or the PlayStation 5, but for the price, and even the PC people have to go and say, yo, that's a good deal. For $300 for 1440p at up to 120 frames per second with ray tracing and an SSD, which, by the way, the SSD is an NVMe SSD, the fastest SSDs that are out there. Like, even PC people got to say, that's a good deal. For only $300, it's insane. I know it's not as powerful as all the other ones, but for that price, it is amazing. But of course, this brings us to the information that broke once I finished recording this video just a second ago. And that is that not only is this thing, all the price came out, the specs are epic, but on top of that, the release date was revealed, and it's going to be November 10th. Which is nice, because it's right before the next Call of Duty release, and I think that's the only real game that I'm aware of that's launching with these consoles that's cross-gen and all that stuff, or cross-console, I guess I should say. So, you know, that's interesting. I like to see that. I get playing my new Call of Duty game right on next-gen right away. I love that. But regardless, it makes me question, when is PlayStation 5 coming out, and if the PlayStation or the Xbox Series X is going to come out alongside the Series S. It makes me question that. But either way, this brings us to what we got to talk about and how this is going to affect the Xbox Series X and the PlayStation 5. And we'll first start off with the X, because honestly, if the rumors are true and the Xbox Series X is going to cost $500, like, I mean, sure, some people are going to buy that, but I imagine most people are just going to get this. Like, most people are going to just pay for the cheaper thing. If they could get next gen for $300, I just don't really see how the average customer who just wants next gen is not going to get this over the Xbox Series X. Like, I know some people love their specs and all that stuff, but, like, you know, I just don't know. We'll have to wait and see. I personally, how I see it playing out is that more people are going to buy this by far. I just think that more people are going to buy this over the Xbox Series X. I think the X is going to be, like, the thing for just the people who have extra money, and everybody else is just going to get this. That's honestly how I see it playing out. But more importantly, how is this going to affect PlayStation? And honestly, with this move, I'm going to be honest, I think that Xbox just gave themselves a huge edge on winning this next gen race against PlayStation. And the reason being is because you think about the two reasons why people buy consoles. The first one is price, and the second one is specs. And PlayStation ain't got either of those. the Xbox Series S is going to be cheaper, and the Xbox Series X has better specs. So what does PlayStation have here? What does PlayStation have to offer? And I just really don't know. I mean, they're going to say games, which is fine. But again, it's not one of the main reasons why people buy it, at least that I'm aware of. Like, the two main reasons when people go into a new console is because of those two things. So I'm just at this point where I'm wondering, like, what does PlayStation do? Like, currently, the rumors for the price of the PlayStation 5 is insane. Like, the rumors currently are, and again, this is not true. We don't know if this is true. This is rumors, but the rumors are is for the optical version, the one that has a disc drive in it, that is going to cost $600, and the all-digital version is going to cost $500. And even if that's currently the price, PlayStation got to change that, because if they're selling at that price, ain't nobody buying that. Ain't nobody going to be buying that. I won't even buy it at that point. That's way too expensive when we got something like this. But I think the only way PlayStation even competes right now, honestly, is if they drop the all-digital version to $400 and the optical version or the disc version to $450. Like, I really don't see how they figure out either way. Like, they can't be the same or more than the Xbox Series X at this point. They just can't, because they won't. Like, I just don't see them winning in any other way. They at least have to find maybe that middle ground. Well, we're not as powerful as the Xbox Series X, but we are more powerful than the Xbox Series S. But that's why we land right in the middle, because we're more powerful than the Series S, so we should be more expensive. But we're not as powerful as the Xbox Series X, so we should be a little bit cheaper. And that's the only way I see that PlayStation even competes this time around, if I'm being completely honest. I mean, we'll see. This will be the huge testament to see if games are really the biggest seller in gaming. But to me, it's always been about price. I think price has been the number one thing in that really sells. And, you know, I just don't see how they compete any other way, shape, or form. But anyways, guys, that's all my thoughts on this current situation. I'd love to hear what you guys are thinking about this. You guys liking what you're seeing, liking what you're hearing? You guys liking what you're hearing from Xbox? What are your thoughts on how this is going to affect PlayStation? I'd love to hear all those thoughts and opinions down in the comments, because I shared mine, and I'd love to hear your guys', because I think PlayStation is kind of in a bad place currently. But anyways, that's about it for me. If you guys did enjoy the video and you guys are excited for next gen and you want to see more, then definitely like, subscribe, bell, share, and all that great stuff, because we're going to be definitely covering all that. I'm going to be getting these consoles, and it's going to be amazing and all that stuff. But anyways, I'm going to go catch you guys next stream video, or wherever the heck it may be. And laters, guys.